Hello guys and welcome to TechWolf. In this video I'm going to show you how to host a WordPress website. We will also create a WordPress website from the very scratch. We will install it on my local computer. I will create it on here on my local computer and then I will show you how to host it. And we will be hosting our WordPress website in HostGator. If you are interested more in WordPress development or programming, or you have any questions in some programming languages or anything, you can feel free to ask me. So as I have different videos already created here in web development and programming where I am creating different tutorials. I have also here a video how you can install XAMPP environment, which we will be using to host our WordPress website on our local computer before we will be sending and hosting it on HostGator. If you don't have XAMPP environment already installed, you can also come in here and watch a video. It only takes 5 minutes to install that. First thing what we will be doing is I will show you HostGator, which is hosting platform where you can buy a hosting, and hosting is needed to host your website so people are available to access it on internet. I will not be buying hosting because I already have bought here hosting, and on this HostGator I have hosted this techwolf.site, guys. If you're interested, you can come in and check techwolf.site as well. This is my website which I also built in WordPress and which I have hosted here with HostGator. But what I will be doing, I will remove the techwolf.site from this domain name, techwolf.site, and I will add here another website which we will create just now in this video. So let's stop rambling, guys, and let's get into it, and I will show you how to do it. First thing what we need to do, obviously we need to open an XAMPP control panel on our local environment, and we need to start Apache server. Just click here start, and we need to start MySQL database. Click here start, guys. This means that Apache server is activated and MySQL database is also activated, and all our files for any applications which we are building on our local Apache server is located. If we open any folder, you go into local C and you will see this XAMPP folder, and all applications related to XAMPP are here in this folder. Just click in and here you will find htdocs directory, and in this htdocs directory is all applications which you are building with PHP language, programming language, and so on and so forth, guys, as you can see here, guys. And once we have started our application, we go into local host, and here you can see all this application HTML, Bitnami, CSS, FAI new, FAI coin, Favicoin, ICO, and so on and so forth. And if we open back this folder, you can see this all is also here, and these are all applications which we are building and which are here in localhost, and they are, like I mentioned, located in htdocs directory, as you can see here at the top. C XAMPP htdocs directory. First thing what we need to install WordPress, and we need to extract it also in here into this htdocs directory. We are going now to go to WordPress, and we will install brand new installation to our computer. So to do it, let's go here in get WordPress. In wordpress.org, guys, this is not wordpress.com, but this is wordpress.org, and we click there WordPress, and we here click download WordPress 5.3, and as you see I downloaded it, and WordPress 5.3.2 is installed now in my downloads, so we will not need this anymore, and we need to open a downloads folder, which is here, guys. Click in downloads, and here you can see WordPress 5.3. I will just double click on it and I will extract it. Here we just highlight this WordPress and we click here extract to, and we are extracting it also to local disk. As you remember, in XAMPP directory, double click and one click only on htdocs, because we are extracting into this folder. So one click, not open it. And we click OK. And now this all WordPress has been extracted, and we can close this and we can go back to local disk. We can go into XAMPP, htdocs, and here you will find this WordPress. I will change this WordPress to my site. You can call it however you want here, but I will call it my site. We'll click out, and here we have now my site. And if I will go here now in localhost, if I will refresh it, you can see this my site directory, guys. I just need to click it in, to start installation. But before we start installation, and if I click my site, you will see this language check. But before we start installation, I will open another browser window and I will type in localhost / phpMyAdmin. And now we are here on our databases, or in my MariaDB database, or also this is the same as MySQL database. And here I click here into home icon and click into databases to create a new database here. Once you click this home icon, databases, you just type in there as well my site or however you want to call your database. I'm calling it the same as I have called my website main folder, guys, just for purpose of this video, guys. And click create, and this database, as you see, my site is created. And currently if I click it here on the right hand side, it is empty. There are no tables and no data in this my site directory. So guys, we have a database now, and now we can start proceed with installation or creating WordPress website on our local PC. And here we select language. I am using English, so I will be clicking here English United States, continue. And here it is saying that we need to prepare database, database user, database password, and we have done it already. So let's click proceed. And here, where is database, we are writing simply my site, because we created database my site. And where is username, we type in root, because root is the main user for like MySQL database. And if we don't have created a specific user for the database, we simply type in here root. If you would have a specific database, you would type that username here for that database which you have created for that website. And we will have it on our hosting provider when we will create a database there, and I will show you that also when we will get there. And for password, we don't have any password because we didn't create a database, and we have only main user, which is root user. And localhost database host is localhost because we are developing locally and it is located on the same server as on our computer, guys. If you have database somewhere else on some other server, some other IPs, then there you would type IP or internet protocol for that database in this field. Otherwise, it would be always localhost. And click submit and run installation, guys. And here I also site title, I will call it my site just to keep it very simple. And username, locally I will type Bugatti, and my password will be Bugatti123. And you can type email here, guys, your email, because this is email. For example, if something is wrong or your site gets broken, there is such a page where user gets redirected and he can contact administrator. So this will be email he will be contacting to. And discourage search engines for indexing this site. You don't never ever click it. I don't even need know why they have created this option, because if you are developing locally anyway, internet is not, or search engines are not able to access your website, because you're creating locally on your local environment, on your local computer, and it is not connected to internet. Confirm use of weak password, because I'm using very weak password, it wants me to confirm. For example, if I will be creating on production server, my password will be much more complicated. Here I click install WordPress, guys, and this will make our installation, and we have created our WordPress website. And then I click login, and then I click login again, guys. And I will show you now how your website looks for now. And you see here my site, guys. Just click on this icon and it will open your site, and your site currently looks like this. And how to create a WordPress website. So I also have different tutorials here on my YouTube channel, Web Development and Programming. If you want some specific tutorials, you can also ask in comments or contact me privately, guys, and I can show you how to create some specific functionalities or some specific website, because this is very easy and very fast to do with WordPress to create your websites, because as you can see here, we already created a website. And if we would want to change, for example, design of this website, this is also very easy. We go here in appearance, for example, we click here add new, and here we can select how we want our website to look. For example, if I would want my website to look like this, I can just preview how it will look, and then I click install and it will install this theme, and then we just will activate this theme. I will actually do it now, guys, and I will click activate, And if we go back to our website now and we refresh, you will see that we have now totally different design guides to our website. And this is the website which we will be now hosting to our HostGator instead of techwolf.site. Next thing, we will talk about HostGator. I just wanted to show you that now if we click in here into my site, you can see that we have data, we have database, and we have database populated. We have tables here in our PHP MyAdmin. And here, if we click into VP_users, you can see that here is one user, which is Bugatti, and its user password is encrypted in MD5 encryption. I just wanted to show you that now here in my site we have tables. These all are tables, and each of these tables have data which is supporting all data which is displayed on this particular website, localhost, my site, which we will be now moving to hosting, and we will be moving it to HostGator, guys. In HostGator, like I'm always mentioning, don't buy WordPress hosting. As you can see, there is button WordPress hosting. Never buy that one, but go with web host. It gives you much more capabilities than working with WordPress hosting. And to do it, let's click into web hosting. And the best thing, to my opinion, which I'm using always myself, is Baby Plan, because here you can host unlimited websites by using this as a shared host. Use it as a shared hosting and host as many websites as you want on this Baby Plan. However, if you are planning to host only one website, then Hatchlink plan would be okay for you, but I'm always going with Baby Plan. And to buy a hosting, you simply click here buy now, then at the top here, as you see, register a new domain name. If you don't have a domain name already registered somewhere, you can select the domain name here, some type in something, and here you are selecting extension for the domain name, like .club, .net, .host, .space, .tech. I have .site. As you can see, mine is techwolf.site. Once you have selected your domain name, you proceed and you fill out all your details, your emails, for how long you want to buy that hosting. As you can see, for 1 month it would be $11.95, for 3 months it would be $11.95, for 12 months it would be $5.95 a month, and this 36 months would be $3.95 a month. And then you fill out all details and then you make payment, and once you will make your payment, guys, you will receive email. And as you see, email would look like this: no reply, HostGator, your account information. And this your account information will include couple of details. It will include your cPanel or control panel, where you can access it and from where you can manage your databases, your files of your website, and so on and so forth, which we will be also accessing in a second, guys. So I will close now this hosting off, guys, because I will not be returning to it. But we will go now and we will go through my email. I will go to your account info. Like I said, I will hide this my user. As you see, there is a link, your control panel, then you have your username, and then you have your password, guys. And your username and your password is needed to log in into your control panel. Click on that link, guys, and your control panel will open, and you need to log in there by using your username and your password. And this is how cPanel looks like. And cPanels are used for different co-hosting providers, and they are managed by VHM, or web host management, which is higher level software or lower level software, on which which is managing these cPanels or control panels. You will normally, as a user, you will have this control panel, which will look exactly like this, where you can add your or manage your websites, guys. And as you can see, we have here PHP MyAdmin, and we have in databases MySQL databases, and we will need to create a database here. So to do this, let's start with creating database. Create MySQL database, and here create a new database. We are typing in database name. I will type it my site. And here note that at the beginning there is a prefix bigbug_mysite. So your database name will be bigbug_mysite, not only my site as we created it. So create database, guys, here. Go back. So database is created, and we need to create a user also for this database. And here we see the button create a user, guys. And to create a user, we need to type in here username. I will also type in my site user USR guys, and for password I will add some simple password, which is Bugatti123, because I will be deleting this dot anyway guys. Password again guys, Bugatti123, just to confirm password and create user. And now we have created the database here on our hosting, and we have created our user, and now we need to add this user to this database. And to do that, we need to scroll down, and here you will see this add user to database. And here in first field you select your username which you created, so username is bigbug_my_site_user, and database is bigbug_my_site, and click add guys. And here we will need to specify with that we want to give all privileges, so all rights to use this database to this user. And we click here all privileges at the very top, and we click make changes. And once this is done, we can go back and we can click here on HostGator. Because we have created now database, we have created a new user for this database, and that is done. And now we will need to import our database from our computer to our hosting, and to do that we need to go back to our local host phpMyAdmin. As you remember, we created the database, and here on the right hand side just click in my site, just click on it, and then we here on the top you will see this button export. There is import export, but we need to click export, and here we need to export SQL file. This is a file which contains all these tables and all information for our website which we have created guys, which is this website on our local computer. So click here go, and this will, as you see at the top, at the bottom my site.sql, we exported this file, and we can close this our local host phpMyAdmin database because we will not need it anymore. And now we need to export also these files which are for our website, and to do that we also open simply any folder here, then we go local disk XAMPP htdocs, and here we, as you remember, we have this my site directory which is our WordPress website. We just right click, and here we go into send to, and here we compressed zipped folder guys. Let's send to compress zipped folder, which means that we are compressing all our files into new directory. As you see, my site.zip, it will be directory which we will need to upload to our hosting. And how to do it I will show you just in a second once this is done now guys. And now we go back to our host here, we go back to databases, and first thing what we will do is we will install all our tables from our local environment from that SQL file. To do this we go here into phpMyAdmin, and here in phpMyAdmin click here on databases, and here we see bigbug my site database. As you remember, this was the database which we created, bigbug my site. As you see, if I click in there is nothing now, but here we click this button import in this phpMyAdmin, and here you will see choose file. As you see, browse your computer, so choose file, and we need to import this my site.sql file which we created, as you see, PostgreSQL file, and just open it and click go, and this will install our database on our hosting. This also can be done by control panel. If you are exporting huge databases, you can do it by your control panel. But if you have any questions with huge databases, you can also contact me privately, I can help you with that as well. If we now click into bigbug my site, you will see that we have the same tables here, and we in each table, if we click here now into VP users, you will see that we have our username, which is login details for our website which we created locally. This is Bugatti, and encrypted password. So we have updated our database, so we will not need database anymore, so we can close this database. And now we need to update our files, and here as you see in our C panel of HostGator we have this file manager. Just click here where you can see files. As you see here guys, there is file manager, just click on it, and it will open our file manager where we can manage all files for our website. And here you will find this public_.html, And if you click on this, here you will see now files. I have their files, and these files which you are seeing here right now, guys, these are the files from my techwolf.site. So I will remove them for now, and to do this, I will create a new folder. As you see, there is the button plus file plus folder. I will click on plus folder. I will create a new folder. I will call it here, and I create new folder here, and okay. And as you see, we have now here another folder, and in this folder I will move all these files into this folder, guys. Actually, this one, this folder as well in here. So, and if I will go now to techwolf.site, I will refresh it, you'll see that there is nothing, because we just removed these website files altogether. And to do this, next thing what we will do here, in click, make sure that you are still here in public_.html, and public_.html folder on hosting is the same as your folder in your htdocs directory. If we go into my site, guys, all files for your website has to be extracted here in this public_.html, and this is where your website is being read from, and the index, like your index file, has to start from here. So guys, now next thing, we need to click this button upload and upload that zipped folder which we created. So click this upload. Here we select file, and we go back into local disk, we go into XAMPP, we go into htdocs, and here we go into, as you see, we grab this file, my site. This is zipped folder, guys, and we click open. And now it will install all these files onto our hosting, and all this folder to this hosting. And then we will extract these files, and then we will move these files to public_.html. And as you see, it's now downloaded it. Now here at the bottom, go back to home, and we click there, and here we see this file. So we click on it, so it's highlighted, then we right click on it, and we click here extract, guys. And it will ask to extract public_.html. You just click yes, guys. And now this folder is extracted. As you see, this is extracted folder, and this is our zipped folder. And I will right click on zipped folder, and I will delete it, because we don't need this. And I will go into my site directory now. So let's double click, and I will highlight all these files. And again, I will right click, and I will click move. And I will delete my site from the end, because I want to move these files back to public_.html, guys, to that public_.html directory, guys. So move files, and now I go here on the right hand side, public_.html, and as you see, all files have been extracted here. And here we have this directory, my site, from which we moved these files, so we don't need this directory anymore, because it is empty. So right click and delete it. So confirm. And now if actually we will go now to techwolf.site, guys, you will see that nothing is still working. It's saying error establishing database connection. So everything is okay, files are there, but we still not able to establish database connection. And to resolve this problem, we need to go back into public_.html. We go into this config, VP config file, search for VP config, as you can see file, and you right click and you click edit this file. There is edit, and we click edit again. And here you will find at the very top this MySQL settings parameters, which we will need to set to these new parameters, because we created another user, as you remember. So as we created another database here, so we have a password as well here. So as you see, database name, DB name, here it is not my site anymore, but this is big bug, as you remember, big bug underscore my site. As you remember, we created a new database, and its name is bigbug underscore my site. So database user is not root user anymore, because this is config from our local host, but we need to change it to this database user which we created here. And this is also bigbug underscore my site usr. As you remember, we created the username and we assigned this username to this database. And we have also database password, which we didn't have on our local environment. As you see between these quotation marks, we are adding a password, which was Bugatti123. And it is hosted on the same local host here. Like I mentioned, if your database would be somewhere on another hosting, then this would not be local host, but that would be IP address of that hosting where your database is hosted. If for some reason your database would be on another server, not here on the same server where you are hosting your website files. And we click save changes and we go back to our website, techwolf.site. We refresh it and it should be broken. As you see, it is broken, and it is broken because it needs to be debugged, guys. I will show you how to do it as well. But everything is working, database is connected and file systems are connected. So what we need to do, we need to log in. So /vp-admin. Okay, vp admin, here we click advanced, proceed to localhost. Oh no, this is localhost, we don't need to localhost. As you see, techwolf.site. And here, as you see, techwolf.site, now it is okay, guys. So yes, this is pretty much how you host a WordPress website. And if you found this video useful, leave a like, share this video, subscribe to my channel. If you have any questions, leave them in comments and see you in the next one.